Hello teacher, sa video na to, pag-aaralan naman natin yung halimbawa nung ginawa kong Activity Completion Report or ACR in our reading program. Okay, so ano ba yung halimbawa nung ating Activity Completion Report dahil natapos na nga natin yung for the school year 2021 to 22. Kailangan natin of course mag-accomplish nung ating accomplishment report that we may include in our Activity Completion Report. So what are the parts? Ano yung mga dapat content o yung content na nilalaman nito? So ano ba yung ilalagay ninyo dito na para makatulong sa inyo sa paggawa ng inyong report, especially in reading program? Okay? Muli kasama ninyo si Teacher Bean. Bago natin simulan itong video na ito, kung di ka pa nakasubscribe sa akin dyan, please click yung subscribe at yung notification bell para mag-i-updated ka sa mga educational video. Okay, so meron tayo dito halimbawa ng ating Activity Completion Report. So, first part is our project title. So, kunyari, may project title kayo. Ito halimbawa, a school-based English reading program for elementary learners. So, for October 2021 to June 2022. You may edit here, pwede nyo ilagay dito ano ba yung project title nyo kay na ginawang reading program for elementary level or high school level. So, yun yung part 1 ng ating Activity Completion Report. Part 2 is yung project proponent and location. Of course, dito pwedeng ilagay yung name ng school at yung proponent, yung gumawa ng class ng reading program. At yung location, ano name ng inyo? School, yan yung part 2. Okay, pangalan ng school at yung nag-propose nung or yung pinaka-proponent ng reading program in your school. Then for part 3, we have the rationale. So we have include here in the line of 289-2021 Implementation Guidelines of DepEd Memorandum Number 173 to 2021 Bawat Bata Bumabasa. So, nag-base ako dun sa memo na nilabas of our DepEd about Base English Reading Program for Elementary Learners entitled blank. Ano yung title ng program? This will help and support the curriculum implementation of our division, your SDO, or your being for the EPS in charge are of the same intent and address of response in the reading instruction and reading difficulties of all learners in elementary grade level. So, may you may include in your rationale what ano yung naging basis of your program, anong memorandum or order ang naging sources of your reading program to make this work. Okay, lalagay nyo doon. Next, we have the project objectives. For our project objectives are expected outcomes. Of course, your mission of doing this, ano yung lalagay nyo dyan sa part 4. For my reading program to intensify the school advocacy for reading, to work together with the division office to improve quality education, produce independent readers, significant enhanced pupils learning, and increase community awareness on the importance of learning to read. So, pwede po dito your own purpose or missions of doing this reading program. Ano yung mga expected outcomes ninyo based sa reading program na ginawa ninyo? That will be in the part 4. So, ano-ano yun? Ano yung mga dapat nila expect through your reading activities? Next, project beneficiaries for part 5. For part 5, of course, our name of school, anong grade level, kung may specific grade level ba, or all the grade level from grade 1 to 6. So, ilagay nyo po dito. So, yun yung part 5. Kung sino yung makaka-benefit sa inyong program. Okay, then, work plan, ito yung program matrix natin. Of course, nag-start yung last school year natin for October. Nagkaroon kami ng ano yung mga activities na ginawa ninyo on that preparation of your reading program on in your planning. So, online meeting with your our district supervisor, sino yung mga responsible person. So, ito yung part ng work plan eh. Month, anong time, anong date, activities, ano yung gagawin, and then yung responsible persons involved. Ito by English-English coordinator, or yung mga teachers, or school principal. So, ayan. So, may monitoring of banking of reading materials, all teacher grade level, PSDS in charge. Ayan, for October, we have the meeting with the parents, conduct of field ERI, distribution of reading materials, yung mga English teachers, mga teachers in different grade level, teachers, and school head. So, ayan. Nag-launching tayo ng mga different reading activities na involved sa ating reading program for October 2021. Then, ito yung mga involved, mga parents, learners, school head, and English teachers. Ayan. So, for November, ayan, dito na tayo. Yung I tell you, may body, 12 o'clock reading habit, ECD or English conversation daily, monitoring and evaluation. Yan po yung mga sample ng mga activities under our reading program, in our reading program. We have the I Tell You, it's a weekly storytelling by the teacher from grade 1 to 2, can be facilitated through online or asynchronous or synchronous classes, okay, or giving some instructional reading materials that can be helpful with the guide of their parents. My Buddy, it's a pair reading. Kung may mga siblings sila doon or mga ka-grade level na kapitbahay, pwede yun. Distance learning. And 12 o'clock reading habit. So, there are 30 minutes silent reading during, pwedeng everyday or weekly. And yung mga ECD, it's a English conversation daily na ginagawa namin monthly na binabasa ng mga students about some celebrations, about personal information, what's your name, how old are you, pwede po yun. June. Then, ayan, so December, ganun pa rin, same pa rin. Dapat po, in our monthly, there is a monitoring and evaluation of the English teacher's coordinator or reading proponent or reading coordinator in different grade level. Dapat minomonitor yan. So, there is submission of MOBs, okay, you observe them through the reading activities, through online classes, pwede po yun. So, yan, January to February, same pa din. Then March, ganun pa rin, implementation of reading, I Tell You, My Buddy, 12 o'clock habit. Ayan, easy deep conversation daily. So, ang mga involved po dito yung mga English teacher, mga learners natin, 1 to 6 parents, guardian, and principal, and school head. Same with the May. Sa April, ganun din po. For May naman, dito na tayo nag-conduct ng ating assessment ng ating post-test for EGRA and PILEAR. So, last week of May or pwedeng first week of June to. So, nagkaroon din tayo kasi nung PILEARI and EGRA for grade 1 to 3 and 4 to 6 PILEARI. So, English teachers, parents, and guardians. So, meron dito for June, ito na yung completion ng report, submission of accomplishment report. So, consolidating a report. Okay, so, pwede po yan. So, part 6, pwede po tayo maglagay ng highlight of the activities. Ano-ano yun? Pwede mga short narrative with the teacher. Like, yan, online orientation, meeting of English-based reading committee. Yan yung preparation. Yung pagkakasunod yung ginawa yung reading program activities. Pwede kumuha kayo ng mga pictures depend, based on your work plan. Okay? Yan. And then, short descriptions or narrative. Ayan. So, yan. Pwede po lagay dito picture. Okay? Then, online orientation. Kung nagkaroon kayo dito ng school-based reading program. Online orientation meeting with the parents and teachers. Pwede. Ito na yung implementation nito, monitoring, evaluating, yung pagbabanking of reading materials in a Google Drive repository, administration of EGRA and PILEARI playtest. Ayan, picture po sa baba, pwede nyo ilagay. Uploading and accomplishment of ME tool and class school reading program. Ayan, nagkoconcentrate na report. Administering of monthly reading assessment. Ito na yung pre and post-test of PILEARI and EGRA. Pwede po dyan, lagay kayo ng pictures. Yung mga activity din during a online class, yung mga picture nyo doon, ilagay nyo din po. Pwede yun. Yung My Buddy, yung 12 o'clock habit na ginagawa, or kayo nagkakaroon ng ECD English conversation daily, how you implement it, insert a picture sa highlights and of the activities. Yan yung part 6. And then we have here, ayan, prepared by, of course, lagay nyo po, school English reading coordinator, school English coordinator, reading coordinator, and approved by. Okay, sino yung ating approved? By yung ating principal and with the note of our SDS, school district supervisor, okay, PSDS, then yan, school reading coordinator with the e-signature or sign po. Ayan, so sa paggawa po ng activity completion report, napakadali lang naman. Of course, dapat alam nyo talaga kung ano yung naging how you execute this program, paano to nakatulong, ano yung na-achieve ninyo, ano yung mga naging outcomes in the whole school year. Medyo, of course, it's very hard for this type of pandemic, pero pwede po siyang maiba dahil meron na nga tayong mga limited face-to-face classes. Kung nagkakaroon kayo nitong last school year, how you implement the reading program during that limited face-to-face classes, kindly insert that. Pwede nyo pong ilagay yung pictures, some narratives are in the matrix or plan. Pwede po siyang maiba din. Okay, depende sa inyo on how you implement the reading program. Ano yung mga ginawa nyo pa, kung meron pa kayong mga celebrations or short activities weekly, okay, so motivational activities about your reading program, you can include that in the highlights of the activities. So, that pwede pa din siya magamit in the next school year. Pwede nyo siyang ma-share with the next reading coordinator, pwede po siyang ma-add. So, ganun lang kasimple. Basta, ilagay nyo lang talaga yung mga naging important activities Okay, ano yung naging mga evidence of outcomes, like yung mga naging resulta ng PIL-IRI, na EGRA, in your post-test, ilagay nyo po. Ano yung, kung meron kayong mga suggestion din or other recommendations, pwede rin po siyang ilagay dito on how this activity can be improved again for the next school year. Ngayon magsisimula na ng ating face-to-face classes. So, ganun lang po kasimple. Bawa ng ating, napakasimple lang naman, ng ating activity completion report for reading program. It's very important because, of course, this is your this is the evidence of your hard work. Diba? Ito yung proof of hard work ninyo in implementing and doing the activities of reading program. Okay? So, kung may tanong po kayo, kailang mahiya, type nyo lang sa comment section sa baba. At if nagustuhan nyo itong video na, please click the like button. So, maraming salamat.